Students, now let us solve the third problem. Third problem under the transportation problem. A company has received a contract to supply gravel for three new construction projects located in towns A, B and C. The construction engineers have estimated the required amounts of gravel at these construction projects. So problem is given that so the project location is A, B and C. The weekly requirements in truckloads are given to be 72, 102 and 41. The company has three gravel pits located in towns X, Y, Z. The gravel required by the construction projects can be supplied by three pits. The amount of gravel which can be supplied by each pit is as follows. So here we are given that there are plants here, so X, Y, Z. So coming down here, we have 76, 82 and 77. This is a truck loads, the amount available. So these are all the cost matrix. So 4, 8, 88, 16, 24, 16, 8, 16, 24. Schedule the shipment from each product in such a manner so as to maximize the total transportation cost. So we have to minimize the total transportation cost here. So what we can do here is we have to just find out that the total plant availability is, okay, so 76 plus 82 plus 77, which adds up to 235 truckloads. So if you go by the weekly requirement, it is 72, 102 and 41. So if that works out to 215. So here there is the truckloads exceed the total requirement by 20 truckloads. So this excess which is there, it has to be handled by adding a dummy project location. So we have to add an D excess. So this is the extra column that we add up, which is equal to 20. So here the transportation cost that we assign will be 0. Okay, so the modified table is, I'll work out the modified table now. So this is a modified table. So here we have the costs as 4, 6, 8. So 8, 24, then 16, 8, 15, 24. So these are the ones which are given cost details. So this is added and the cost that we assign is 0. So now we'll have to arrive at the initial basic feasible solution. We can adopt any method for that matter, northwest corner method, least cost method or the value added VAM method. So VAM method will give you the least cost, so to say. So VAM method is usually taken up. So initial basic feasible solution, if you do by VAM method, so you will be able to arrive at the feasible solution at the earliest. So now let us calculate the penalties. So we calculate the penalties. So penalties will be calculated in such a way that we take up the two most least costs. The difference between two most least costs, 4 minus 0 is 4. Then here it is 16 minus 0, 16. So 0 and 8, so 8. So here it is again 4, 8, 8 and 0. So likewise we'll have to calculate, right? So here the highest penalty is this. So we have to allocate the this thing here. So allocation will be done. So we actually go by the least cost from among the highest penalty row or a column. So here we have got a row. So here this is the least cost from among the costs that we have. So I allocate 20. So I'll be left with 0 here and 62. So I'll be able to cancel this. Now again we'll have to calculate the penalties. So here it will be two least costs will be 4 and 8. So it will be 4. Here it will be 16 and 16, 0. So here again it is 8 and 16, so it will be 8. So coming down here, 4, 8, 8. So this is not there because we are done with the allocation here. So if you identify the highest penalty, we are having in three cases. So usually what we do is we go with that particular penalty where we can allocate the maximum at a least cost. So here, if you go with this particular cell, 8 is again here, right? So I will be able to allocate 72. So here if I go with, so I will be able to allocate only 41. So if I go here, I'll be able to allocate 76. So this is the here I can make the maximum allocation at the least cost. So what I do is I go with this penalty row column, sorry. So here identifying the least cost, it is 8. So I make a allocation of 76. I am left with 0 here. So here, so 26 is what I'm left with, right? So again, this is cancelled. So again, I have to calculate the penalties here. So no more will be able to do here. So coming down here, it is 16 minus 16, it is 0. So coming here, 8 and 16, so 8. So if I go by this A4, so I am left with 16 and 24, so 8. Again, 8 here. So no more will be able to. Again, we have three values which are having highest penalty. So as I told you, we will have to go by that particular. So I did a small mistake here. So 8 and 16, it is again, it is 8 here. Sorry. So we are having 8 in 4 cases. So we usually go by that particular cell where I can make the maximum allocation with the minimum cost. If I go with this penalty, again I come here and I will be able to allocate 72. If I go with again here, I will be able to allocate 72. If I go with this, I will be able to allocate only 26. Sorry, 77, that too. The cost is high, right? Comparison with this. So this is ruled out. Here also, the cost is high. So 8 is a least. So I will go with this penalty. So if I compare this, 72 is what is allocation I can make. So I'll be able to cancel this. And I'm left with 5 here. So again, we'll have to calculate the penalties. So again, we encounter the same thing. In 4 cases, the penalty is similar. So what we do is we just find out. So here, the minimum cost is 16 and 16, right? So here, I'll be able to allocate only 5. So here, I'll be able to allocate 41, so at 16 rupees. So what I do is I'll go with that particular column where I can make the maximum allocation. So 41 is a allocation I can make. So I'm left with 0 here. So it is 21. So finally, we are left with only these two. So it is 21 and 5. So this is how we make the final allocation. So I will now calculate the number of allocations, right? So number of allocations is equal. The number of allocations are 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So it is equal to m plus n minus 1, which is equal to 6 and 6. So when this condition is satisfied, we can do the optimality test, right? So I will just redraw the table again to do the, now we can do optimality. I'll redraw the table and we will do the optimality test. So I am taking up the allocations here. I am writing down the same allocations which we have done in the previous so that you know there will not be any confusion. I cannot calculate UI and VJ values, so it will be a bit too confusing. So I am just redrawing drafted the table so that we will be able to do the optimality test. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so this is what is the table 2. So table 2, now we'll have to do the optimality test. So for computation of the optimality test, we have to calculate the UI and VJ values, correct? So the formula we already know, right? So for calculating the UI and VJ values, So it is just that we will actually find out the cell which is having the column or a row which is having the maximum allocations. If you see, this B is having the maximum allocation, so I write 0 here. So 0 plus 8 is 8, 0 plus 24 is 24, 16. So after having calculated these values, we actually go with the allocated cells. 16, I have to deduct 8 to arrive at 8. So then 24 I have here, so I have to get 0 as a thing. So what I do is I write minus 24. So 24 is here, so I have to add up. Is it not? So here we have 24, and to arrive at 16 I have to deduct 8. Now here after having worked out the UI and VJ values with the help of the formula CIJ is equal to UI plus VJ, we have to calculate the DIJ. DIJ is nothing but CIJ minus UI plus VJ. So these are the opportunity costs that we need to arrive at. Now let us see, we have to calculate the DIJ values for unallocated cells. So here it is 4 minus 8 minus 8, so it will be 4. And here it is minus 8 and minus 8, 0. 8 minus 0 is 8. So here it is minus 16. So 60, 0 minus of minus 16 is 16 here. So we have applied this formula and calculated the values. So here minus 8 and 24, we get 16. So 16 minus 16 is 0. So coming down here, 8. So it is 16. So minus 8, so it is 0 minus 8 of minus 8 is 8. So if you observe here, all the DIJ values, all DIJ values are greater than or equal to 0. So this is optimal solution. So we can work out the total cost. So total cost is equal to working out the allocated cells, 8 into 76 plus 24 into 21 plus 16 into 41 plus 0 into 20 plus 8 into 72 plus 16 into 5 plus, that's it, I think. So if we add up all the values, we get the cost to be rupees 2424. This is the least cost that the company can attain with this allocation. So this is about this particular problem. Thank you.